right, there we see it, Jake Cerrone. The three guys who all the same night held the Florida title here in the AWF. It was back just last month. Jason Moore was your champion, supposed to wrestle Spanky Malone, but instead, Raven Beasley, a.k.a. Rabies, comes out, attacks Spanky while he's signing autographs, no less, during their intermission, puts him out of commission. Then, as you talked about earlier, Gene Beard, the matchmaker, not here tonight, he decided to tell Rabies, I tell you what, you can have this title match, but if you lose, you're out of the AWF title shot. See, Rabies took it up on it, a little bit of cheapness going on, he was able to come out the winner, but then Cockiness got the best of the only homeless wrestler in the United States of America, as he calls anybody from the back. Little did he imagine, taped with it all, Spanky Malone will come out, and he would become the new Florida champion, and that's why you've got all this tonight. During that melee, Rabies put Spanky Malone through a table, and then you have a match I've never seen before. It's not just 2 out of 3 falls, it's not just a tables match, it's both. 2 out of 3 falls, tables match.
My goodness, Aaron, if I tried to say that myself, I'd need an oxygen tank. Rabies taking over there and hit tosses Spanky Malone. An interesting footnote with the three of these gentlemen. These basically been the three competitors that have been circling around the AWF Florida, not only since last month, but also basically since the inception of that title in February.
Now, you've had a few of your guys, that's not to say Jason Moore only defended against these guys. He went in there and defended his title against the likes of Michael Christopher, against the likes of Jarrell Clark. A very successful title reign, but these have definitely been the main players, and they're still going at it. Is it going to end tonight? Somehow, I don't think so.
No, I don't think so either. Both men right now trying to size each other up. Rabies starting is going to go power for power with Spanky Malone. He may want to rethink that.
Oh, God, look at the power of Spanky Malone. Very, very popular here with the fans. Rabies, not so much.
No, Ben Spanky Malone right now coming in full force, but Rabies, able to see him, takes him up. Malone comes in with a Corona. Hard Corona there by Spanky Malone, or at least it likes his takedown.
Oh, look at that. Kind of a Rana flying head scissors combination there by Spanky Malone. Didn't know he could fly like that, I gotta say. Rabies landing right on his head. And I don't care who you are, that can't be good.
No, it can't be. Rabies, again, the shortest reigning ever AWF Florida champion. I want to say that title reign was about a 9 or 10 minute title reign after he boasts he was going to be the longest reigning champion. So he's a little short of his goals.
Well, that obviously didn't happen. What you've got to remember here is Jason Moore, he's had friends with both of them, but he's had a respectful, competition-based war with Spanky Malone. He can't be a very big fan of Rabies. Is that going to come into play? He says he's going to call it down the middle, but how can he be expected to not have any feelings about this match? And as you can see, this is anything goes right here. AWF style match. Oh, it throws him right into the repos. He's thought he was going to fall on his head, but instead he falls right on his butt.
Rabies got just whipped into that post. Rabies, who's been in a lot of crazy matches, been in that hardcore match with Michael Christopher that involved the thumbtacks. The first time the AWF was here in Auburndale, he had the match for the AWF Florida title against Jason Moore, which used two tables, including him getting chokeslammed off the top of a ladder by Rise.
Well, if anybody's seen Rise, you do not want to be up that high and getting chokeslammed, that's for sure. 7 foot monster. But right now, one thing Spanky Malone must not be wanting to be doing is being in this position, as he's right now got Spanky Malone where he wants him. He looks like he's going to go on top. This hasn't worked very well for most people so far.
Look out there. That security guard right now having troubles with Benny Bennett. That security guard is actually kind of instrumental in the title. Just caught by a chair. He was instrumental in the title win for Spanky Malone, so they're having problems out there.
Absolutely, but that might be just a little bit of break that Spanky Malone might need to get himself out of this. As you said, Benny Bennett down there. But like Jason Moore said, this is all legal. If nothing can be done.
Are you kidding me?
Rabies. Can either of these guys even keep going? But Rabies gets up, but he can't win the match there. He's got to get him to the second table and try to put him through it. I missed what happened there. Looks like he got crossed by Spanky Malone.
Either that or I believe it. I know he was trying to go for a leg drop. It looked like wherever it was, he landed on a very metallic piece of that table. The security guard being carried back in the dressing room by referee Frank Gastineau, and we get to the action here at ringside, and how Spanky's able to get back up on his 2 feet is an absolute miracle.
Well, he's being helped a little bit by Rage, but we saw in his brutal, brutal matches with Snow that this guy can take a beating, literally the beating of a lifetime, and come back swinging. He took that beating last month and came back and won the Florida title. Spanky Malone is far from out of this match.
You're absolutely right. If you put a roadblock in front of Spanky Malone, you better put money on the fact that Spanky Malone can go through that roadblock. But I'll tell you, it remains to be seen whether or not he's going to be able to recover from that frog splash.
Okay, they got it back in the ring. I really didn't think there was going to be a whole lot of this going on. Both these guys can wrestle, but obviously with the hatred, they've been just brawling each other. Oh, look at that nice offensive moveset there by Raby, showing some different stuff.
Raby's coming in. Nice job kick off the ropes. Again, Jason Moore, basically, even though he's a special guest referee, he doesn't have to do a whole lot. He's just there watching the action, front row seat. There is no pinfall. Someone forgot to mail the contract to Rabies, apparently.
Yeah, well, apparently Rabies knew what was going on when he put him to the table, but you get in that heat of the moment, and you kind of forget what's going on. I'm guessing the lack of a sustainable iron supplement in his diet probably isn't doing too much for his brain power, right?
Yeah, maybe a little too much used hamburgers out there, that trash can. Right now, Spanky Malone in a lot of trouble. The Lakeland, Florida native. About to beat Tornado DDT by Rabies. Instead, Spanky Malone.
Oh, beautiful suplex. And I told the Spanky Malone right back in the thick of this match.
Spanky Malone able to slingshot him right off the ropes with that suplex. And now it's Malone who's got to take the offensive. Malone who's taking the initiative, the champion. Going in with a left hand on Rabies.
Okay, one thing we get to talk about, how absolutely beautiful was that frog splash by Rabies. I tell you, this guy gets a bad rap as just a hardcore brawler because of his homeless nature, but he obviously has some wrestling training. Don't know how he got it being homeless and all, but he obviously has. Oh, and look at that. Just as I say, what great conditioning and training he's in. Absolutely bullied over by Spanky Malone. Huge leg drop, and the power of Spanky Malone starting to come into play.
It is absolutely coming into play. As you were talking about Rabies, it's not only myself, but a lot of people feel like he is one of the most underrated wrestlers in the state of Florida. But right now, that's not going to help him if he can't get himself up and get Spanky Malone through the table.
But he is up one to nothing, so no matter what we say about Spanky Malone's resiliency, and he has it right now as Vantage Rabies. Wow, that sounds like a bug spray of some sort, doesn't it?
Just to let the fans know, he did get checked by the Florida Department of Health. He does not actually have the disease. So that's...
No, but I've tried him many times, just calling him Raymond Beasley III. He doesn't seem to like that too much.
No.
I don't really know what he's got or anything, so I just call him Rabies.
And since he has a very interesting case of body odor, you just want to stay away from him anyways.
Being nice, but, you know, well, we got to call it down the middle, exactly as you said. Jason Moore saying that's what he's going to do, but as you said, what can he really do? All he could really do so far in this match is throw Rabies, there's no pinfall, and just basically be there to make the call official, because you've got to have someone make that call.
On the edge of the ring right now, Spanky Malone throwing a couple of fists over to Rabies. Both men, I believe, are near the table on the other side of the ring. Rabies is going to try to go for the pin. He's going to try to win a Florida title right here with a suplex on the outside of the ring, trying to go through the table.
It's going to be very hard to suplex a guy quite as large as Spanky Malone, and he hasn't been able to, but if he keeps wearing him down, beating that back, that's the way to do it. Up and over, nice roll over. Rabies off the ropes, comes up